Hello, I'm Bob, and this is the Home Bitcoin Immersion Mining Channel, and in this episode, I'm going to compare propane heat with Bitcoin mining heat. But before getting on with the video, I want to mention some sponsors and affiliates of the channel, the first being Brains. So Brains is now selling their BMM 101 mini miner. And if you are just starting out, learning about Bitcoin and Bitcoin mining, this is the perfect miner for you. The BMM 101 mini miner can run off of any household power source using only 40 watts. Just plug it in, connect it to the internet, and start mining. You can explore what it is like to generate hash rate, join a mining pool, and mine Bitcoin. It is the perfect starter platform for you to start your own home Bitcoin mining journey. And for a limited time, if you click on the link below, you'll get a 10% discount on your own new BMM 101 mini miner. Next up is Fold. Fold offers a really cool Bitcoin debit card where you can get rewards in sats from your normal day-to-day spending. I've been using the Fold card for over a year now, and I've already accumulated almost 1 million sats without changing any of my normal spending habits. The card works with the Fold app, where you can buy and sell Bitcoin, buy gift cards, and set up direct deposits and payments, making it super easy to live on a Bitcoin standard. And if you sign up now using the affiliate link below, Fold will give you a bonus reward of 20,000 sats on your very first Fold card purchase. The Fold card is a great way to start living on Bitcoin. Just click the affiliate link below to get started today. Okay, so on this channel, I've spent a lot of time talking about how to build home mining setups and how to integrate them with home heating systems. I've got links below if you want to learn more or if you want to see how I've built Bitcoin mining heat into my own home. But a big question to ask before you start heating your own home with Bitcoin mining is, does this make sense? You have to look at the equivalent cost of other heat sources and compare them with the cost of Bitcoin mining and really understand that trade-off. This trade-off will be different for different types of heat sources, so it helps to focus on a specific fuel. And so for this video, I'm going to focus on propane heat. Now, here in the US, propane is generally used to heat homes that are not connected to natural gas. These homes are generally further away from cities, and so the gas has to be trucked in on a regular basis, which adds considerably to heating costs. In addition, propane-heated homes are generally in more rural areas, and often the cost of power is lower than normal consumer rates, sometimes as low as 5 cents per kilowatt hour. And so, substituting Bitcoin mining heat for propane heating in these scenarios can often be a good idea. But we have to do a little math to understand where that trade-off makes sense. And the first step is to look at the cost of propane heating. Now, in the US, propane is priced per gallon, and for most homes, propane is delivered by truck, which adds a delivery fee. And companies will often add other service, taxes, and other miscellaneous fees to that bill. Sometimes these fees are listed separately, and sometimes they are grouped into a single combined cost per gallon. So for this video, I'm going to keep things simple and just use a single cost per gallon that includes all fees. The next step is to convert propane heat in gallons to propane heat in kilowatt hours. Unfortunately, there is a bit of variation in the quality of propane, so there is no perfect conversion number here. Looking at a bunch of different online sources, I'm going to go with the best conversion value I found, which is around 268 kilowatt hours per gallon, and this means the cost of propane per kilowatt hour is simply the cost per gallon divided by 268. Now, I'm also going to assume that all of the heat generated by the propane fuel is used by the home. Modern high-efficiency furnaces can hit efficiencies greater than 90%, and so assuming 100% efficiency is going to give the best case for propane heating. Now, taking a look at Bitcoin mining, there is the cost of the electricity used to run the miner, and then there is the Bitcoin revenue earned by the miner. Now, the key parameters here are hash price and miner efficiency. Hash price is measured in dollars per terahash per second per day, and this is a measure of the dollar return miners get for providing hash rate to the network. Miner efficiency is measured in joules per terahash and is a measure of how efficiently a miner converts electrical power to hash rate. Both of these parameters are really important to understand when getting into Bitcoin mining, but I'm not going to get into these in this video. If you want more information on hash price and efficiency, I've got a link below to another video where I explain both of these in more depth. Now, combining the cost of propane with the cost of mining, we get a simple cost ratio. If this ratio is equal to 1, that means the cost of propane heating is equal to the cost of Bitcoin mining heat. If this ratio is less than 1, Bitcoin is cheaper, and if the ratio is greater than 1, propane is cheaper. Setting this ratio equal to 1 and putting this on a graph, we can see how all of this works together. This is the break-even line. If your cost of electricity and cost of propane puts you greater than this line, Bitcoin is the cheaper option. And anything on the other side of this line means propane is the cheaper option. Now, the first thing I'm going to do is plot this line for the case where hash price is equal to 0. This would be the case if miners were not mining any Bitcoin, and this is also the equivalent of just using normal electric heat without any mining. And as you can see, unless you're paying over $10 per gallon for propane, electric heat alone doesn't make sense. This is why propane heating is cheaper than simple electric heat in most cases. But this is also where Bitcoin mining revenue can make a huge difference. For example, here's the updated chart with the hash price set to a really low value of 3 cents per terahash per second per day and setting the efficiency to 30 joules per terahash to match an older, less efficient miner like the S19J Pro. With mining revenue added, Bitcoin mining heat now starts to make sense if you have really cheap power. Looking at an even more efficient miner, like the new S21 Pro, this pushes the break-even curve further to the right, making Bitcoin heating cheaper for houses with more expensive power. And if the Bitcoin price climbs just a little, increasing the hash price up to maybe something around 5 cents per terahash per second per day, there's now a huge range of power costs where Bitcoin mining is the more cost-effective option. Now, for all of these calculations and plots, I've completely avoided the upfront hardware and heating system installation costs. I've only focused on the cost of operation. And that's because there's a huge range to how much it can cost to install a propane or Bitcoin heating system. Both can run into the thousands of dollars, and both are going to be very specific to each home installation. Also, the cost of either system is amortized over the lifetime of the system. That amortization rate will depend on how much the heating system is used each winter and how many years the system lasts before it has to be replaced. And so getting back to the big question for this episode, is Bitcoin heating or propane heating better? The answer is, it depends. For each application, you have to look at the specific electricity and propane costs. You have to look at what miner hardware is being used and the current Bitcoin hash price. And you also have to make some assumptions about where all of these will go over the lifetime of your propane heating or Bitcoin heating system. There is no absolute answer here. Sometimes Bitcoin heating is going to be a great opportunity, and sometimes propane heating is the way to go. And if you're looking for a similar comparison between Bitcoin heating and heat pumps, click here.